What's up guys, this is your boy TheAmbitionGamer98 over here, back with another video. And in this video, I'm gonna give you an overview of my small gaming room and the gaming setups that I have in my room that I use from day to day. And this video is gonna be not pretty long, so I'm gonna give you an overview, and you might wanna buy this gadgets as well, so I'll leave a link down in the description as well. So with that being said, let's get started. So the first part that I have over here is my bedside table. At the top shelf of my bedside table, I have a small tree which is given by a friend of mine, a moonlit lamp, a couple of my phones, a small earphone, and a couple of remotes to control the gadgets in the room. So the remote that I took here is actually used to control the light for this moonlit lamp. It's perfectly spherical, looks kind of cool, and you can have actually multiple colored modes that you can use. So this is kind of interesting, and this retails in India for 1300 rupees, which is roughly around $17-18. So this is a gadget that I love using, and it's pretty bright at night as well. So this does get the job done and gives a good effect. This small gadget that you see here, this is actually a magnetic clip that I use it to attach to my LG G8X for charging as well as data cable. So that sums up the first shelf. Let's jump into the next shelf. I have over here are three popcorns. So this is more of a snack shelf, and I have a juice as well. So this I refill from time to time, and for now all the popcorns are actually there, but that's this shelf summed up. So moving down, I have this is a bit messy, I'll say. I have a couple of more phones here and a Duo, as well as some chips and a controller at the back. I think that's not visible because of the less amount of light. Let me switch on the light. So now you can see, like, I have a couple of chargers here as well, one for my iPad, one for my phone, a subwoofer, and the controller, and some drink as well. So this sums up my bedside table, and this is what I had for the bedside table. So let's jump onto the main interesting part here, which is the main table and the gaming table. So the first part that I have over here is the gaming table itself. So this is a good table. I'll not say it's very large and very has a huge width. The reason being, I am living in a pretty small room. So with this being said, this retails in India for around 5,700 rupees, and I got this from Flipkart. So this does the job decently as well. So let's look at the other gadgets here. So let me kind of go closer, and you can see I have the laptop, I have the headphone, I have a headphone stand, I do have a mouse pad with again RGB. I'll be walking over through all these gadgets here, but let's jump into what I see at the bottom. So at the bottom, I have three laptops. So one is for my office uses, and a couple others I actually use very rarely, I'll say. Those were my previous gaming laptops. And the other one that I have over here is an iPad. So with that being said, let's jump into the other aspects of this small gaming room tour. And the other aspect that I have over here is my gaming chair. This gaming chair comes from Pulse Gaming. So the Pulse Gaming makes a decent chair, and I bought this chair because I'm kind of heavy. I weigh over 100 kilos, and this is pretty sturdy. So I love using this chair. It is flexible. You can actually bend it to 180 degrees, and it's pretty comfortable to sit on for the long gaming hour sessions. So this retails in India for around 16,000 rupees, which roughly translates to around, I'll say, a bit of about $250. Let's jump into the next part, which is my laptop, which is powering this entire gaming setup. So I have an MSI GE63 VR laptop, which has 16 GB of RAM, as well as 256 GB SSD storage. And this is a bit older laptop. This laptop is actually old, 3 years old, and thus the graphics card is not that high. It still runs a GTX 1060. I'm looking forward to upgrade it to the RTX 3 series, and I kind of purchased this laptop for around 1.5 lakhs back in 2018, which roughly translates to just above $2,000. So you have a lot of good modes. You could see the RGB color mode for the keyboard. It's per key RGB color as well. So this is a decent laptop, 120Hz refresh rate, so it's pretty decent for gaming. Still does get the job done, but I definitely like to replace it. Underneath it is a cooling pad, which I'm using. It again has RGB. Like you can see, if I'm pressing this button, it could actually change the color of the different colors that you actually have for the RGB. So this is again something cool, and it's kind of required, because although this MSI laptop does have good amount of cooling, I'll still say it's better to have a cooling pad so that you can actually lift the laptop a bit and also get the air flowing. So let's move on to the top. To the top, I have an Redragon Scepter RGB headphone stand, as well as Ant Esports headphone actually that I'm using. So for the headphone stand, this headphone stand retails for around 1700 rupees, which is just a bit above $20 in India. So this you again get with a lot of RGB modes. You can change the color, you can get a lot of RGB modes here as well, which is something again like a gamer gene, I would say. So it does get a lot of RGB. The headphone is pretty decent, I'll say. Again, RGB here. This is not a very expensive headphone. This retails for around again 1700 odd rupees in India, which is like around $20. So with that being said, let's jump into the next part of this gaming room setup tour. So here I have a Tag Gamers RGB mousepad. So this again has RGB, and I have a Leviathan Dragonverse mouse. So these two are not very expensive. Totally together, they are around 1500 rupees, close to $20 again. And you have multiple modes for changing the color of the RGB mousepad as well. So with that being said, let's jump into the next part of this gaming room tour. And the next item that I have over here is my racing wheel. So this racing wheel kind of looks cool, and this racing wheel is from Ferrari, Thrustmaster Ferrari, basically Thrustmaster Ferrari racing wheel. It's legendary edition, what it is called. And this is actually a 90 degree racing wheel, so you can just rotate it by 90 degrees and not like 900 degrees. So you can see, like, I'm just rotating it, it's just 90 degrees, comes back to its own position. And this is kind of cool. You have a couple of pedals, one for the acceleration as one for the brake as well at the bottom, to match up with the racing wheel. So this is kind of cool for the racing games that I play, and I do play a lot of racing games. I have completed like almost all the Need for Speed series, so definitely it's something fun and I enjoy playing with it. With that being said, let's jump into the next part. I have a small speaker, Bluetooth speaker, nothing fancy over there, and so I'm not explaining a lot about it. It retails for around 600 rupees. With that being said, I actually kind of forgot to mention about the price of the Ferrari racing wheel. That is around 6,000 rupees in India, which roughly would translate to around $90 USD. And let's look at the monitor here. I have an Acer Aopen 27-inch curved monitor with 165Hz refresh rate. So definitely good for gaming, as the high refresh rate is pretty interesting, and you could have seen the curve there as well. At the top of my desk, I actually have a photo of me winning in Cyber Olympiad, and on top I actually have just an image of Supergirl. I'm a big Supergirl series fan, so I just kept the photo just like that there, so nothing fancy, nothing decorated there. So with that being said, I also have the LED light strips, which are the XRG like LED light strips, which are actually even remote control. So you do have a version of remote control. I have only one of the LED strips as a remote controlled one, the one that you're seeing at the above. The one underneath the table is not remote controlled. You can actually have a manual control to it. So you can do change the color of the lights as and when required with the remote. Multiple color options is there as well. So you can see here, I'm kind of changing the lights according to my wish with the remote that you had seen initially at the bedside table. So with that being said, this concludes my small gaming room tour. Do let me know, guys, how did you like this gaming room tour? And this is your boy, the Average Gamer 98 over here, signing off. You guys take care, and I'm gonna see you in the next one. And by the way, make sure to like and subscribe, and comment out what changes you might wanna require for my gaming room so that it could be enhanced better. And if you have any other suggestion, please let me know down in the comments below. With that being said, this is your boy the Average Gamer 98 over here, finally signing off. You guys take care, and I'm gonna see you in the next one. Peace.